Kemp. Kemp right now is getting ready to talk. Let's listen in.
Sean, we're at GEMA headquarters. Now joining us is Governor Brian Kemp. Governor, there's so much tension and anger in the city right now. What do you have to say to protesters?
Well, I think, look, the protesters that are here that are demanding justice and wanting to voice their support for, you know, the individuals that we've seen not only in Georgia but in other parts of the country, we support that. We have been working hard to make sure that they can have a peaceful, nonviolent protest, and I think for the most part tonight we've seen that be very successful. The problem is we have some agitators that have a different agenda than bringing justice, and that's what we've been dealing with certainly last night and tonight. I think tonight's a lot different story. We had a great plan working with Chief Shields, Mayor Bottoms, and a lot of local and state assets to be able to respond tonight. Tonight's going very well, but tonight's not over, so we're continuing to keep our foot on the gas.
Last night you activated the state of emergency. What made you make that decision, and how long will that be in effect?
Well, we had the order yesterday. I just actually signed another executive order expanding the state of emergency statewide. We are tracking some protests tomorrow in other cities like Savannah, Athens, potentially Griffin. So we just want to have these resources available to any local community to protect the lives and the property in those communities. That will call up as well the rest of the National Guard, up to 3,000 people if we need them, since we're going to a statewide effort. You know, hopefully we won't have to do that. That'll run through the end of next weekend. Really gives us a lot of tools to continue the response that you've seen here in the city of Atlanta tonight statewide if we need it. I hope we don't, but we'll have those tools available if we do.
It's a lot different story from last night. There was a lot of violence and destruction. How important do you think that 9 o'clock curfew was for tonight?
Well, I think it's two things. I think it was just us working with the city and the mayor, Chief Shields, to really come up with a good plan tonight to make sure we had all our bases covered. We had enough personnel and equipment to be able to do that. I definitely think the curfew was a good move by the mayor and the chief. We told them earlier today we would support their efforts 100% in everything that they wanted to do. You know, I told the mayor that Friday morning, and we continue to communicate that today. So when the curfew, when 9 o'clock got here and the APD officer started moving in to give notice that folks were fixing to start getting arrested, we were there to support them in that, to have their back, if you will. While they were making those movements, we were controlling behind them, watching their six, if you will, and also assisting if needed. And then certainly we have that tool and ability from a law enforcement perspective, as the Guard does through the executive order, to do that as well. And that goes for the rest of the night.
We've seen thousands of protesters out there, not social distancing and even not wearing masks. Are you concerned what this will mean for the coronavirus?
Well, definitely I've been thinking about that. I think right now that's the secondary concern for us from what we've seen. You know, obviously that's very hard to control, especially when you have agitators that have a different agenda than justice. So we'll start dealing with that when things get calmed down. Our first response tonight was to, number one, protect the lives of our citizens and our officers, the men and women that were responding to this, and our first responders. We saw, you know, firefighters in the fray last night and many other people. But we've got to continue to buckle down on the coronavirus, to continue to follow the guidance and guidelines of public health officials, to continue to move the numbers the way they're moving now in the state of Georgia, and continue to reopen our economy.
Did those agitators come? Are they from the city? We are getting reports that they're not even from the city.
We're tracking a lot of that information too. I haven't been able to confirm a lot of that, but I've you know, heard tidbits that airport traffic was up over the last several days with people coming in from out of town. I've heard, I haven't been able to confirm this, that a lot of the arrests made last night, that the majority of those were from other places around the country. And those individuals were involved with some really bad groups from around the other parts of the country. But I really couldn't speak more specific than that right now, because I haven't been able to confirm that.
There were hundreds of protesters outside the governor's mansion tonight. What do you have to say to those protesters? It got tensions rose fairly quickly, but luckily they were continued peacefully protest. What do you have to say to those?
Well, I think the biggest thing is thank you, number one. Most of them, as Colonel Val was telling me, were you know, really following the law, following the guidance that we were given. In fact, many of them picked up their trash and other things when they left, so we didn't have to do that. Unfortunately, like in every crowd, there were a few agitators that, you know, had confrontations with the Atlanta Police Department and were arrested. But really, the majority of those people did what we asked them. I think they got to make their point, and it was a very peaceful and safe event.
Racial tension is at an ultimate high right now. How does the state rebuild after this weekend?
Well, I think the good thing to me, I think that started tonight. When you look at the response, when you look at the backgrounds of the people that are in this room that are serving in the capacities of law enforcement, our National Guard, the partnership we've had with the mayor of Atlanta and her team, really shows that we can put race, partisanship, politics, everything aside to keep our people safe and really stand up for what is the fabric of the city of Atlanta and the social change that has happened here through peaceful protests, which is something I support. And I think Georgians are on board with that as well. I think tonight, you know, unlike last night, if things hold like they are right now, it could be a proud moment for our state.
What was your reaction when you saw the videos from last night and the looting and everything that happened?
Well, it wasn't just the videos. I mean, I was seeing it happening live right here till 3 a.m. in the morning. I mean, it was a tragic event, unfortunate, you know, especially when you have people that are throwing bricks through windows trying to hurt firefighters that are trying to go in and put a fire out and save someone's property. That's just something we're not going to stand for in this state. And I know the mayor believes that, as do I, and I think our response tonight shows that.
And you guys are monitoring the situation in here. What agencies are here, and what are you guys doing?
Yes, we have the Georgia National Guard, the Georgia Emergency Management Agency, obviously the State Patrol. We have the Forestry Commission, Department of Corrections, Department of Juvenile Justice, many others that are involved tonight. GBI doing a lot of GSAC work on intelligence and other things. So we've got a pretty broad team in here, and I'm probably missing some folks too. I think we have Homeland Security here and potentially the FBI as well.
All right. Thank you, Governor, for your time.
Thank you. Have a good night.
All right. That's the latest from the governor at the GEMA headquarters. Let's send it back to you guys in the studio.
All right, Ayanna. Thanks very much. Nice job. Thank you very much, Governor Kemp. Let's